Welcome to FedScoop TV. I'm Wyatt Cash, and we're here today at the IT Modernization Summit. And joining us is Renee Nguyen. Renee is the CIO from NASA. Renee, we're really delighted you could join us.
Oh, it's a pleasure to be here, Wyatt, and thank you for the invitation.
Well, absolutely. Thank you. So we're talking about IT modernization, and we're familiar with a lot of the barriers. But from your perspective, what are some of the barriers you're still encountering that you and other agencies face as a CIO in modernizing IT?
So not to go into a place where it seems cliche, but the bottom line is it's about change leadership. There are two types of changes in our lives as humans, and that is change we want, but we don't think of it as change, and then there's the change that we don't want or the change that we feel that is being imposed upon us. And so what we need to do as CIOs is really focus on how do we change, and to help people with that change that they don't want to take because they have to give up their old equipment, the way they might have done something. And what you do is you try to talk to them about where you're going and give them visuals and really work it. And so what you'll find then too is the more you talk to folks, the more it gets illuminated is what your strategy, both for communication as well as adoption of the new technologies to do that. Wyatt, you'll probably remember the last time you're like, yes, I want to go do something, but it was a change and you went and you embraced it completely. But yet when somebody wanted to take away your IT or change your laptop, you might have been a little bit more skeptical about how that would improve your life.
Exactly. Well, let's talk a little about how you enable your teams to think about transforming to more of a digital operation, not so much about the technology itself.
Yeah. This has been an interesting journey to go a little bit more digital, in part because NASA writes its own software and manages a lot of IT just in the way we do our business in our mission side. And so if I look at our mission support side, and in that side, we were way ahead of the game even a decade ago in terms of mechanizing our processes. I don't want to use the word digital on that one. Mechanizing our processes. And so we're like, okay, it's great. I now have all these forms and that. Well, 10 years goes by and our systems, some of them are still just a form on a screen. And so now we're in that process to say, well, isn't it really about the information? And are our systems redundant? And in that process to ask those questions, then we look at how can we make this more digital? And that is with usability screens and that, and you look at the private sector, you know, we all very powerful with our finger here to get stuff done, and really thinking through differently how we delight our customers by bringing the digital path, not just the mechanized electronic path, which was the one that was used about a decade ago. And you just really have to work the people side for them to realize it's an okay thing to do. It's just about the information.
Great. Well, what systems do you see are most poised right now for IT modernization, realizing we can't boil the ocean all at once?
Yeah. So at NASA, we're basically looking at our mission support side because we're trying to centralize some of our functions. Every center has procurement. Every center has a CIO. Every center has HR. In a time of declining resources and increasing capability through hardware and software, through technology and digitization, we can really start to think differently. And so what each center has a process in HR, and what we're doing right now through our applications office is figuring out one bite at a time learning management, resume efforts, and taking those and making those much more digital process. And then on the contract side, we're even imagining paperless contracts, and so we're also looking at digitizing those process. Those areas are in their nascent stages because first you have to know how you want your processes to work, how you want them to change, and then you can throw some tools at that and bring the smart people into the room. So it'll be a journey for a while because first we have to accept that maybe NASA only needs one system for some of these capabilities, and so we're on that path right now. And we've got some success.
And lastly, let's talk a little about cybersecurity and how it fits into the process of IT modernization, because both sort of work together. How are you approaching it?
So I have two answers to that one, and they build on each other. My hope is during my tenure at NASA is to leave there where we say safety and security is part of the fabric of the way NASA operates. And what I'm trying to do is deliver that security piece to it by to our software engineers, as an example, is to use platforms that check for not only syntax errors, but check for cybersecurity errors and illuminate changes in the way you code that improve the cybersecurity and keep the compiling capability and compute capability at or better in terms of that. And so the nice part is our the private sector are bringing us tools that have some cyber capabilities already baked in to what we're doing, and so it makes it a lot easier for us to be thinking this way and moving this direction. So two things, I want to change the culture for safety and cybersecurity, and I'm grateful to my partners in the private sector for bringing us the tools that allow us to move that direction.
Well, Renee Wynn, thank you so much for sharing just a few of your insights with what you're working on towards IT modernization. Wish you all the luck in the world on that.
Great. Thank you. I'm going to need the luck.
I'm Wyatt Cash with FedScoop TV, and thanks for watching today.